Welcome to this brief guide on how to use Graze for Mastodon. One of the questions I've seen floating around Mastodon the most lately has been, how do I have so much difficulty interacting with users on other instances? Well, today I'm going to show you an extension that helps make that a thing of the past. Here you can see I'm inside my Mastodon client and I'm on my home instance, which in this case is universidon.com. But say for instance I've been connecting with some people and someone sent me a link to their Mastodon profile, but they're located on a different instance to me. In this case, Dan Seifert, the deputy editor at The Verge, he's located on mastodon.social. But he sent me his link and I'd like to follow him, so I simply click the button that says follow. But that didn't seem to work. For some reason I get this pop-up that says, hey, you can't do that right here. It asks me to sign in. One of the things I recommend is don't try signing in, purely because my signing credentials won't work as I'm not a member of this particular instance. So what I would normally need to do is actually copy Dan Seifert's profile link, which I can do using the copy button here, head back over to my instance, search for his profile URL in the search feature, and then I could find him in amongst my search results here, and I have the button to be able to follow him just like I normally would. But that's not really seamless, so there's an easier way that we can do this using a brand new extension called Graze for Mastodon. I'll have the links for both the Chrome and Firefox versions in the description of this video. For those that are utilizing Microsoft Edge, you can also use the Chrome-based version as Microsoft Edge is a Chromium-based browser. So all we need to do on either Chrome or Edge is simply click on the button that says Add to Chrome, and we'll get a pop-up notification asking us to add the extension to our browser. Once we approve that, we'll get a little pop-up that'll let us know that Graze for Mastodon has been added to our browser. Simply clicking on the extension will give us a pop-up where it'll let us know that Graze is designed to allow us to interact with instances other than our own. And speaking of our own, we need to simply log in to our home instance. So make sure you enter in your home instance's URL here and select the Connect Account button. Since I've already been signed into Mastodon in one of the other tabs here, it's automatically going to sign me in. And now I need to just authorize the extension to access my account. This tab will automatically close in a couple of seconds, and now I can simply head back to Dan Seifert's profile, and I'll just ignore that little there, and I'm just gonna give the page a quick refresh. This isn't needed, but I'm just gonna do it anyway. And now that I'm on Dan Seifert's profile, I can simply click that follow button, and I have success. I've been able to easily follow him with a single click, and I can also boost, favorite, or bookmark any of his posts, despite the fact that I'm doing it on his instance of Mastodon and not my own. And that is how you use the Graze for Mastodon extension to make your Mastodon experience as seamless as possible. I hope you found this tip extremely useful, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.